Hello guys, due to the big interest about this HTML and CSS animation, I will show you how to create one inside DragAttack. So this is an object, a web page in a 3D space inside DragAttack, and we can go and insert it in the studio where we can see the HTML and CSS states needed to achieve this animation. What I'm gonna do here is to copy one of the elements of the HTML for the animation directly in the browser with DevTools. Okay. So I'll go a little bit to the left and create another object, another website. And I'll open the studio and insert the HTML I copied from the previous place. First, I'll show you what's the building blocks of this animation. There are such holders with one element inside with certain CSS and bow element also with certain CSS. The most important thing here is that the element, the holder element, is with 220% height and rotation 0. The height is 220 because I want the center of this holder somewhere on the top, somewhere around here. So if that's 100%, we have 120 more up above the holder, above the canvas. And later, when I start to rotate our holder, the center of rotation will be somewhere around here. The next element is the chord, let's say, of the item. It's 100% height, 5% width, and the core is with gradient to look a little bit more realistic. And then we have this bow here, which is with certain width and height inside the holder in order to look like a circle, like a bow. And the other thing is that it has also gradient core for more realistic look here. What I'm gonna do, I'll select this element by double clicking it, and I'll copy it several times. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll have 5 of these inside the canvas. So absolutely the same is to get this HTML and copy it multiple times. That will create also more elements, but I have enough. I have 5 elements already copied with this graphical interface here, absolutely the same to use DevTools. So the first element is to the left by 0. I want 20 for the second. I want 40 for the third one. Sorry, 40 I want. Okay. 60 here. and 80 for the last one. Very important here is the starting value for the rotation, because any animation in drag attack needs start value, and then for the next HTML state we can play with this value to make it different. For example, if I make this 40 degrees, you can see the animation from 0 to 40. Okay, so what will be our animation? I want the start state for the animation to be with rotation of the first element, let's say 45 degrees. So we have the first one rotated, and that will be the start for our animation. And I'll start with the next state. The next state is this element to fall down next to the second one. So what I'm gonna do is just to rotate our element from 45 degrees to 0. The next thing in the animation, I will make it a little bit simpler than the previous video, but I want you to understand the mechanics behind the drag attacks nonlinear CSS animations. So we have this action of falling down the ball, and the next thing we want to do is just to rotate the next one. The next one will be minus 45. So what we have here . That's it. The next step in our animation is this thing to fall down. And I'll turn it back to 0. And now we have 1, 2. And we want to go to the starting position with this thing rotated. And for that purpose, we need to rotate this element to 45 degrees for this last step. But we can do it directly by copying the initial state and putting it here. Now our animation is completed. I'll use the full range of our screen to adjust our animation more precisely. And I'll make it, let's say, 1 second. Let me see what's the result. I think 1 second is a little bit faster. Two seconds is a little bit slow. Let me try with second and a half. I think second and a half is better. And now I'll save this animation to the object I just created. And now we have this animation for our web page, because actually this is a web page. It can be even a platform here implemented, but we have a simple animation for our example. So the next thing I want to do is to create infinite loop of this animation, like here. So you see I have additional if effects here, you can do whatever you want inside the studio. You saw me to change only the rotation here with those steps. Here, for example, we have few more steps for the course and for the appearance, but the mechanics is the same behind the animation. Just pure HTML and CSS states created in the browser and ordered in time, in the time. Yeah. So what I need from this one is this small configuration here in order to make our animation loop infinitely. Here in the data section of our configuration, I say studio logic animation 0 for the internal animation. When the internal animation ends, I want to start again. When 0 is finished, start 0 animation again. And as you can see, we have infinite loop for our CSS animation. And while it's playing, all the elements are absolutely clickable. And you, if you set some functionality, like in a web page, you will have something between a movie and a website, which is very powerful. Thanks, guys. That's all from me. And hope you enjoyed.